Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Slayer, The Legend of Heroes Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're at the Heartwood, where... I forget her name. Helga. Helga, it's her home. She's the mother of Captain Morgan. We just healed him, and then in exchange for bringing nitros to them. They give us these, the explosive darts? I'm surprised they didn't just bombs. I want to buy one of those salts, but I'm not sure. Blast darts, yeah. Alright, so we're going to use that to get through the border pit. We're trying to get to the desert area. So the border pit is south. Kind of southeast, and then turns around to northeast. Okay. My map's a little different than that. Okay, yeah, the map is... Okay, never mind. It looks bigger on the map, because it's zoomed out. Never mind. Just threw me there. So we're across here. You see, I don't think there's any reason to go wander around in there. I gotta look anyway. No, it's nothing. Gotta say... Surprised we made it so far without being attacked. Border pit. Okay. Luckily we got some torches. Alright, we got three, I think. Yeah. Huh. I'm gonna explore it fully for any... There's a dead end. Dead end. I know, I'm wasting torchlight. But I want to find anything that might be... I guess that's a blast. Like any treasure chests or anything like that? No monstries. Am I supposed to blast this here? Ethan places a blast dart under the boulder. Okay. So we blasted that one, but this one doesn't have one. I mean, this one. What's that in the water? That's interesting. That's another blast dart, okay. Wait, can we go that way? No. That in there. Doesn't this seem like the same area? Wait, what is this? Ethan tugs the lever. The water door slams shut. The rushing water slows and stops. Cool. We made it through the other side. But I want to see if there's anything else here. Now I wonder... Kinda curious. If it even shows up. Warp to... Oh, no effect. If we go to Border Pit, which side does it bring us on? That's what I'm wondering. Alright, so items... So is that all we had to do? We needed exactly two? That's pretty good. And we got these things we can't interact with. There's one way we didn't go, isn't there? We blasted it. Wait. That's a treasure chest. I want that. A moon shield? Oh. That's exciting. Okay, so in place of the Doom Plate, we'll defend 220. Alright, so I guess that's our next stuff. Our next set of equipment is moon stuff. That's cool. I like finding it for free, because then you have to spend your money buying it. Stuff's getting expensive. Is this it? We blasted another door, though. Did we go fully through that? A boulder blocks this passage. Oh, boy. I want more torches, and I want to clear that passage. Oops. Alright, so Darkheim sells the nitros. Let's get two of them in case there's another door past that door. And then maybe they'll sell some torches there as well. Plenty of money for it. So I guess we can sell, yeah, the Doom Plate. 13,500 gold. Not selling anything else. No. But we will buy if you have. Nope, he's not selling torches. Sells torches. Levy? And then we gotta go back to Skull Rock. Good. See if we can have four, right? Because I think we had one left. We got one there. And now we got three more. So I think we'll probably end up using at least two. Alright, so now back to Skull Rock. To get two more. Darts? Blast darts. Right. And I'm wondering which side of Borderpit you end up on. I know I'm going right past it, aren't I? So, oh, it's Skull Rock right there. Gotta love this warp spell. I do indeed. Okay. So you want more blasters, eh? Will you fork over nitro? Yes. Get blasters for my bomb, man. I have to do them one at a time. It's awfully limited. These blasters are tricky. Watch it. It's ready, man. Alright, let's get another one. Thank you very much. Actually going to rest in here first. Just to get some of his magic points. Look at that. He's down 500 magic points. So this will give him his MP back. And immediately use some more of it, so... Borderpit. Looks like we start at the beginning. Okay. I don't mind that. I think I'm going to use two of these torches right off the bat. Oh, it doesn't work like that? Wait a second. One. Two. Oh, hopefully it lasts longer. It does spread out a little bit more, doesn't it? We need like a light spell that would do that for us. I think it's through here. Oh! I missed that. A moon spear. How did I miss that? I'm glad I went to the wrong area. Alright. So, Ethan, take Moon Spear. Okay, attack 385. Now, 425. Awesome. Alright, we got that. I'm saving. Locking that in. Alright, so... where? Which place did we end up going through? I thought it was... okay. I love that there's no monsters in here. That makes things a little easier. Ethan places a blast dart under the boulder. Boom. So hopefully there'll be some ultra awesome treasure in here. Hmm. There's another way through. Let's eliminate this though. Yeah, okay, dead end. Mmm. A luck ring. Sweet. Well, we know that's going to increase our luck. Who needs the luck the most? 26. 24. Well, Logan's already got one. A ring. In fact, the only one that doesn't have a ring is Giles, I guess? Lux 27. Well, looks like he's in luck. I don't feel like moving stuff around, so. Have a luck ring from 27 to. Whoa! 77? You know, I think that helps with critical hits, so. Maybe give it to Ethan? I think technically, because. He's gonna be. I mean, Logan and Ethan are going to be more deadly with the critical hits. That's for sure. So take off the speed ring, Ethan. Give him the luck ring. Now his luck's 76. We'll give Giles the speed ring. 31 to 41. That's awesome. All right. Saving again to get that locked in. Okay, so this way is the way we came. So then... oh, that's it? That's it, okay. So that was worth it. To buy two more, although we only needed one. But I didn't feel like going back and forth, back and forth. So, now we're going to make our way back through this way, I think. Alright, we got that. Let me just make sure there's nothing else. Okay. Yeah, okay. Can't interact with that thing anymore. We can get a better look at the water door. Now that I expanded my field of view here. I made it out. Yeah, I know, I keep saving. So now, from here, we can go around. We can go through here. Leads us to, looks like a dungeon or cave called Hollow, I think? At least it looks, yeah, it looks like it's a cave. But then if we go down south and to the east, there's a place, a town called Havlok, and a djinn tower, which is probably full of monsters. Let's check out Havlok. Yeah. See, we got Sylph Invasion. Sylph Death. They're attacking. Oh, dizzy and fell asleep. Oh, I hate that, because we don't have a way to combat that, at least not yet. I wasn't sleeping. Wake up, lazy bum. Nice, whoa. That was a hit for 1,500. That was awesome. 2,000 gold from these things. Sweet. Really, really damage us hardly at all. Alright, so around the mountain. Petal Moss want to devour Ethan. Why him specifically? Petal Man? Petal Maw. It was Petal Maw. I was right the first time. Oh! Sonya's gonna level up. Yay! Alright. Strength, strength. 8 inch. Speed 29. I mean 30. Lock 24. Saving again to lock in those choices, and we are going this way. Wait. Oh, no, it's there, I see it. Tch. What's up with the poison here? Aren't they pretty, though? What if they smell good? They smell a very flowery scent as they're poisoning us. Oh, we escaped? Ugh. I'm robbed. Robbed of pure victory. Havlok! Oh. It was so quiet there, I was like, this is ominous. Got a bed here. Ernie says, hey, you must be more bounty hunters. More bounty hunters? You came because you heard about the reward for ending the invasion, right? I can spot a bounty hunter a mile away. You need some local help? I'll let you stay here, but I need 3% of whatever you get. Sound fair? Sorry to keep you standing. Grab some shut-eye. I guess we don't have a choice. Is he really getting 3% of our stuff? Finish things up quick. I kind of need cash. Alright, I guess from whatever we get from here on in. Ethel says, my husband hasn't seen that dancer because he was hunting near Oasis. Don't say nothing to interest him. Okay. Is she his side piece? Or the dancer is the side piece? Housewife says, in Port Sword, north of here, there's a crazy inventor. Right, yeah, I heard of him. He's been trying to fly in a giant kite that he built, but I'm sure he crashed every time so far. He's always dragging pieces home through the desert. Sounds cool. A giant kite. Tradeswoman says, welcome to Havlok. I run this place. What do you need? Well, first, we'll sell the blast dart. So you don't need that. Thanks a heap. Would you have in mind? Come back now, you hear? Alright, what do you have to sell? Have a look at my stock. Oh, yeah, we got... Oh, a potion. The potion's all yours. That's an improved healing. It might... Yeah, I wish I knew. I got the manual on my desktop, so I don't have access to it once I exit out of the game. I can know what it is. Aunt Tilly says, "You boys look out for that dancer that's been hanging around town. She's even got King Theos wrapped around her finger." Okay. Pastor says, I have no interest in dancing tarts. Seeker, help us. Those people. Is this part of some castle around here or something? That's the same person I was talking to, yep. Haven't you heard? They say Princess Mika is to marry a foreign prince. Nope, I haven't heard that. You look alright to me, but stay away from that Sandra. Men who watch her exotic dance just ain't the same, or aren't the same. Oh, yeah. So maybe she's like a sylph. Yeah, I don't... Okay, let's go up through here. See what's going on. Is there more? Is there more, yes. Oh. Alright. Let's just see what's around here before we go into the triumphant music area. Oh, dead end. There might be nothing, indeed. But I must see for myself. Yep, there's nothing here. Alright, never mind. Back to the triumphant music. Logan says, "Good afternoon. Are you the queen?" Queen Clara says, "And who are you?" I guess from the name, she's the queen. "Were you or were you not motioning to Claire?" Logan says, "I am Prince Logan of Farlane." "Prince Logan? Can it really be you?" "I declare," says Queen Claire. "Where is Princess Mika? She must greet her future husband." "Her future... Did you say husband?" "But didn't your mother ever tell you? We decided on your 5th birthday." "Well, that was nice of them. His Majesty and your father are best friends, you know." "Incredible." Sonia says, "The princess can wait. We need to know where all the men from your city have disappeared." "We've gone crazy. Soldiers, townsmen, even King Theos. Not long ago, a woman came to Havlok and caused quite a to-do with her dancing. Of course, word reached His Majesty, so she was invited to the castle, even though we don't usually divulge, or indulge, in such things. Sandra's her name. Since His Majesty first called for her, he's been crazy over her dancing. He's in the throne room now, with most of the menfolk of Havlok." Logan says, "We've just come from Norland. I'm in hot pursuit of a master villain named Drax to avenge my father." "Drax? And your father?" "I declare." "But Drax was a respected baron. I can't believe it." Ethan says, "It's true. Drax plotted to take the throne of Farlane. He assassinated Corwin, and even sought Prince Logan's life." "I declare!" I guess that's why she's called Queen Claire. "I have dreadful news. The same Drax is in this castle now." "No kidding," Giles says. "That dog came to sort us just like we figured." Logan says, "We'll send him to the Seeker. Queen, where's he hiding?" "He was upstairs with King Theos, but no one can get in that way now. The king forbids to be disturbed." Giles says, "But there's no time to waste. We have to snap him out of it." Sonia says, "But if we force entrance, the king may be harmed." "That's a point," Giles says. Ethan says, "This has gone too far. Drax's evil designs are afoot." Queen Claire says, "It seems just yesterday that Logan was in diapers." "Okay, come on, Claire, focus, will ya? And now look at him. If King Corwin were alive, how proud he would be." "Yeah, let's get on to the matter at hand." Hudson says, but why is Drax here? Could this Sandra be a spy? Maybe working with Nadja, the demon we heard about in Darkheim? I declare, did you say Nadja? Yes, Ethan said. We heard rumors of a Beastmaster hiding in Sordis. Are you familiar with the name Nadja? I have heard it before. My royal nanny was an old woman named Jessie. When I was a child, she told me a story about the Blue Dragon of Chaos. That's right, Nadja is a dragon. That night I was so scared I couldn't sleep alone. I'm sure the name she used was Nadja. You'll find Jessie living in Cardis. I'm sure she remembers the story. Sonya says, psst, Giles, I wonder if this Mika is beautiful? Giles says, I bet she is. After all, she's a royal princess. What's the matter with you? You look distressed. Ethan says, what are you two whispering about? Nothing, Sonya says. Nothing at all. Let's go. Okay. I don't want to do the whole thing over, but she might have something new to say. Just say I sent you. Okay, Cardis. Lady-in-Waiting says, I overheard some talk. King Theos prevents entry to the throne room while he's busy with that traveling dancer. Secret knows what's going on up there. The only doors are in front and from the roof. Someone had better find a way to the roof and see if they can talk some sense into the king. There might be spies in there. Indeed. Well, I want to go there last so I can explore everything else. I guess we take those stairs. Oh, I didn't mean to run into you. We can't get past her, so we got to walk all the way around. Yeah, there's nothing around here. Oh, you have some magic? Magic man. If it's magic you seek, I'm here to provide. Ooh, we got flame 4. Wait. Hold up. Flame 4. Okay. Yeah, we'll replace this one at least. She's got flame 3. I mean, maybe we want to keep a few flame... No, let's just replace everything with flame 4. Throw caution to the wind. I do desire more. Not even done with your first spell. Even looked at the others. Flame 3. And then Shock 4. Who has Shock? Let's just replace Shock 3. There's that one. So glad the spells are free. Okay. Ice 4. Wow, Cure 4. See, I like Cure 1. I guess we'll write over Cure 2 with it. I like Cure 1 because you can top off with that. And Cure 3 does 500. So let's write over Cure 2 then. So Cure 4 is 100 magic points, so I'm willing to bet it heals 1,000 hit points. That's quite a lot. Because we don't even have double that yet. I desire more. I always desire more. Cure 4. Place this chaos. Now, who is this, Giles? Giles only knows Cure 2. Yeah, if I had it available, I'd put Cure 3 there and leave him just with that, but I'm just gonna leave it as is for him. 3 of us know Cure 4. That's good enough for me. Okay. Mute 2. Okay. Waste 3, we already have. I think Sonya has that. Mute. I never use slow. I'm gonna put it on slow. And waste 3 we have, and then psycho 3. I'll just replace with that. Okay. Thank you very much. How do I get out of here? Alright, there's, like, something else here. Is that a courtyard? Oh. Nothing much over here. Alright. Looking at my timer and I ran into her. Okay, just in case something horrible happens, I don't have to do those spells over. Oh boy. Oh. Oh. Okay. She's entrancing them with her feminine dancing wiles. Oh boy. Nobleman says, Dada, Mama. Royal Guard says, Sandra, Sandra. Well, oh, I can't get in. I think I want to head for those stairs there. But when I move down, D- There was another place. She said a roof? There's another way up? Oh, like here? Is this the roof? But we can't get anywhere from here. Certainly looks like a roof. Oh, I have to talk to... Wait a second. I have to hit it just right to talk to... Okay, King Theo says, I ain't never felt this good. Join the party. I still can't get in. Alright, you got me. Must be Drax there. I am not sure what to do. Okay, I'm gonna have to think on this, but I guess that'll be it for this episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.